After a massive storm left a trail of destruction right across the city.
Is North America on the verge of a catastrophe? NASA's most recent startling results call into question everything we thought we knew about climate change and its consequences. So buckle in as we explore the unexpected twists and turns of Antarctica's ice trends, the mysterious North Pacific cooling phenomenon, and the climatic events that are reshaping the planet's fate. NASA's recent disclosures call mainstream climate change predictions into question. Contrary to popular belief, the North Pacific is cooling while Antarctica is expanding. These unexpected findings call into question beliefs regarding the effects of climate change on polar regions. These newly observed increases in ice buildup contradict existing models as climate researchers debate the complicated interplay between rising surface temperatures and weather patterns. The cooling trend in the North Pacific contradicts predictions of global warming effects, while Antarctica's growth defies predictions of ice loss. These inconsistencies highlight the need for a better knowledge of climate dynamics and the effects of diverse causes. NASA's findings illustrate the intricacies of our planet's climate system and highlight the continued need for rigorous scientific inquiry to deepen our understanding of the intricate causes of climate change. The primary source of uncertainty in predicting the rise of global sea levels lies in the anticipated acceleration of Antarctica's ice loss as the planet's climate continues to warm. Recent findings from two research studies, both spearheaded by scientists at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California and published on August 10, 2022, provide unexpected insights into the mass reduction of the Antarctic ice sheet in recent decades. The first study, featured in the journal Nature, delves into the alterations in the Antarctic coastline due to iceberg calving, the process where ice breaks away from a glacier's front. Over the past 25 years, research reveals that the ice sheet's edge has been shedding icebergs at a faster rate than it can regenerate. This revelation is particularly astonishing as it revises earlier estimates of ice loss from the Antarctic's floating ice shelves since 1997, now indicating a shift from 6 trillion to 12 trillion metric tons. This loss of ice through calving has not only weakened the ice shelves, but also facilitated a swifter flow of Antarctic glaciers toward the ocean, consequently intensifying the global sea level rise. In another study, documented in Earth System Science data, an unprecedented level of detail illustrates how the thinning of Antarctic ice, brought about by the melting of ocean waters, has extended from the periphery of the continent towards its interior. In fact, the western segments of the ice sheet have seen nearly a twofold increase in thinning over the last 10 years. Together, these complementary reports present the most comprehensive panorama to date of the transformative shifts transpiring within the frozen expanse. Chad Green, a scientist from JPL and the lead author of the calving study, succinctly captures the situation, stating, "Antarctica's periphery is disintegrating. As ice shelves diminish and lose strength, the colossal glaciers of the continent tend to accelerate, consequently amplifying the pace of global sea level rise. The majority of Antarctic glaciers follow a path toward the ocean, culminating in expansive floating ice shelves that can reach remarkable dimensions of up to 2 miles in thickness and span 500 miles in width. These ice shelves operate as supportive barriers for the glaciers, preventing them from directly sliding into the sea. When ice shelves remain stable, they undergo a natural cycle of calving, where sections break off, and rejuvenation, maintaining a relatively constant size over extended periods. Nevertheless, the warming ocean has introduced instability to Antarctica's ice shelves in recent years, eroding them from beneath by initiating a process of melting. This has led to a decrease in their thickness and overall strength. The thinning process has been monitored using satellite altimeters, which measure alterations in the ice's height. Prior to this study, a comprehensive evaluation of how this thinning process, caused by climate change, might influence calving around the Antarctic coastline had been lacking. This gap in understanding is partly attributable to the complexity of interpreting satellite imagery. Chad Green elaborates, highlighting the challenge. For instance, envision scrutinizing a satellite image and attempting to differentiate between a white iceberg, a white ice shelf, white sea ice, and even a white cloud. This has always been a formidable task. However, we now possess a wealth of data collected from various satellite sensors, allowing us to gain a lucid understanding of the evolution of Antarctica's coastline in recent times. In their fresh investigation, Green and his fellow researchers amalgamated satellite images captured since 1997, employing visible, thermal infrared, and radar wavelengths. By combining these measurements with insights into ice flow garnered from an ongoing NASA project mapping glaciers, they meticulously delineated the perimeters of ice shelves along approximately 30,000 linear miles of the Antarctic coastline. The rate of ice loss due to calving has surpassed the natural growth of ice shelves to such a degree that researchers harbor doubts about Antarctica's capacity to regenerate to its dimensions before 2000 by the close of the century. In fact, the findings propose that more significant losses are on the horizon. The largest ice shelves in Antarctica seem to be on course for substantial calving events within the next 10 to 20 years. In a complementary investigation, scientists from JPL have merged nearly 3 billion data points collected from 7 space-borne altimetry instruments. This amalgamation has resulted in the most extensive uninterrupted data set to date, tracing the fluctuations in the ice sheet's height, a key gauge of ice loss, dating back to as early as 1985. The team harnessed radar and laser measurements of ice elevation, boasting accuracy down to centimeters to craft the most finely detailed monthly maps of ice loss alterations ever generated. This comprehensive record of data uncovers intricate patterns influenced by both long-term trends and annual weather cycles, shedding light on the mechanisms impacting the ice. It even captures the oscillation of the ice sheet as subglacial lakes cyclically fill and drain, hidden miles beneath the surface. Johan Nilsson, the lead author of the study at JPL, elucidates the significance of these subtle shifts, particularly when combined with a more enriched comprehension of long-term trends from this dataset. By amalgamating these subtle shifts with our enhanced grasp of long-term trends from this dataset, researchers can enhance their understanding of the processes that drive ice loss, thereby refining predictions of future sea level rise. Condensing and scrutinizing the immense reservoir of measurements to produce a single high-resolution dataset was an endeavor requiring years of labor and thousands of hours of computational effort on NASA's servers. Nilsson attests to the substantial value of this undertaking. The effort invested in consolidating the data into a more widely applicable format could potentially propel us closer to the significant breakthroughs necessary for a deeper comprehension of our planet and for bolstering our preparedness for the forthcoming consequences of climate change. But what about why the North Pacific is cooling? El Niño is a natural phenomenon characterized by periodic warming of sea surface temperatures in the central and eastern parts of the Pacific Ocean. In contrast, La Niña refers to cooler than average sea temperatures. Both El Niño and La Niña have significant impacts on global weather patterns. These occurrences transpire roughly every 2 to 7 years, with durations typically ranging from 9 to 12 months. Though instances of longer persistence can arise. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration suggests that El Niño tends to appear more frequently compared to La Niña. The classification of an El Niño event entails a temperature increase of at least 0.5 degrees Celsius above the long-term average in the tropical eastern Pacific, as outlined by the Met Office, the National Meteorological Service of the UK. Regarding the current year, scientific observations indicate the presence of El Niño conditions. The NOAA affirmed this ocean warming occurrence in a statement issued on June 8, 2023. A former El Niño advisory was released by forecasters acknowledging the existence of El Niño conditions. The confirmation of an El Niño event for this year will depend on the continuity of these conditions through October. Michel Leroux, a physical scientist at NOAA's Climate Prediction Center, emphasized that the impacts of El Niño can vary in magnitude, encompassing outcomes such as heightened risks of heavy rainfall and droughts in specific global locations. During an El Niño period, regions that already experience above-average temperatures could potentially break temperature records. El Niño and La Niña hold significant meanings in the context of climate and oceanic phenomena. The impact of these phenomena is particularly significant. In normal conditions, trade winds, the prevailing east-to-west winds along the equator in the Pacific Ocean, drive warm water from South America toward Asia. This process facilitates the replacement of warm water with nutrient-rich cold water from the deep ocean, process known as upwelling. Upwelling fosters the growth of seaweed and phytoplankton, microscopic organisms that form a crucial energy source for various animal populations. Coastal upwelling zones are among the planet's most productive ecosystems, supporting vital fisheries. However, the El Niño and La Niña climate patterns disrupt this equilibrium. These phenomena are collectively referred to as the El Niño Southern Oscillation Cycle. During El Niño, the strength of trade winds weakens, causing warm water to shift eastward toward the western coastline of the Americas. Consequently, the upwelling of cold water is subdued during El Niño events. During La Niña, there is an intensification of trade winds, driving warmer water toward the Asian region. Concurrently, off the coast of the Americas, the process of upwelling intensifies, leading to a greater ascent of cold, nutrient-rich water to the ocean surface. The precise cause of El Niño and La Niña is not fully understood. El Niño significantly influences weather patterns, causing the Pacific jet stream to shift southward from its typical position. This alteration results in drier and warmer conditions than usual across northern regions of the U.S. and Canada. In contrast, areas such as the U.S. Gulf Coast and Southeast experience heightened rainfall, often leading to increased instances of flooding, as noted by NOAA. Marine ecosystems are also impacted by El Niño. The diminished or halted upwelling of cold, nutrient-rich water during El Niño leads to decreased levels of phytoplankton, a primary food source for many fish species. This dearth of food extends up the food chain, affecting creatures reliant on fish, including seabirds and marine mammals. In India, El Niño's influence is frequently linked to its impact on the monsoon season. This phenomenon results in below-average rainfall, contributing to severe drought conditions. Between 2001 and 2020, India experienced 7 instances of El Niño, with 4 of those years marked by drought and reduced summer crop production, according to the Economic Times, an Indian news outlet. El Niño's influence on winters brings contrasting impacts to different parts of Europe. Northern Europe experiences colder and drier conditions, while Southern Europe witnesses increased rainfall driven by the shifting jet stream. In the UK, El Niño-influenced summers tend to be hotter and drier, as reported by the Met Office. Switching focus to La Niña, the presence of cold waters in the Pacific Ocean causes the jet stream to shift northward. This alteration often results in dry conditions in the southern U.S., accompanied by heightened rainfall and subsequent flooding in the Pacific Northwest and Canada. La Niña years usher in distinct winter temperature patterns. Southern regions typically encounter warmer temperatures than usual, while northern areas tend to be cooler. Additionally, La Niña can intensify the hurricane season's impact. The amplified upwelling during La Niña offers a boon to marine ecosystems by ushering nutrient-rich waters from the depths. The colder waters along the Pacific coast attract a surge of cold water species, such as squid and salmon, to the Californian shoreline. In India, the presence of La Niña can spark increased rainfall and a notably robust monsoon season. Meanwhile, the UK experiences a propensity toward wetter conditions during its summers, as noted by the Met Office. El Niño is characterized by an unusual warming of the eastern equatorial Pacific Ocean, typically encompassing a vast area from the South American coastline to the west of the dateline. This phenomenon is accompanied by a shift in the location of tropical precipitation over the Pacific, termed the Southern Oscillation. Its counterpart is La Niña, marked by abnormally cold waters in the eastern equatorial Pacific Ocean and a corresponding shift of precipitation towards the west. Together, these occurrences constitute the El Niño Southern Oscillation phenomenon. As of now, NOAA has declared an El Niño advisory, signifying the presence of ongoing El Niño conditions that are projected to persist. For the confirmation of an El Niño event, these conditions are anticipated to extend through October. While different national weather services have slightly varying criteria, there's general consensus that if the present conditions endure or intensify, an El Niño event will be confirmed. The typical duration of an El Niño event spans around 9 months. These events generally form during the summer or fall of the Northern Hemisphere, peak in intensity during the winter, and come to an end in the spring. Strong El Niño events often transition rapidly to La Niña. That's all for today. Don't miss out on the latest updates about climate change. Hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss a moment of our thrilling exploration. And share this video with your friends and fellow nature enthusiasts. Stay tuned. Until next time.